So with this we move to verse 32.
सर्गाणामादिरन्तश्च मध्यं चैवाहमर्जुन अध्यात्मविद्या विद्यानां वाद प्रवदतामहम्
ओ अर्जुन ऑफ मैनिफेस्टेशंस आई एम द बिगिनिंग द मिडल एंड ऑल्सो द एंड. Of knowledges, I am knowledge of the self. Of debates, I am reason. Now, you know, those of you who were present yesterday might say, oh, don't tell me he's going on and on about this. But remember one thing, he's speaking the language that Arjuna understands, obviously, because he's listening. If Krishna were alive now and he was speaking now to all of us, he wouldn't talk about Adityas, I'm the sun and moon and so on and so forth. You know what he would have said? Among cricketers, I am Sachin Tendulkar. Among tennis players, I'm Roger Federer. Among Bollywood artists, I am Aishwarya Rai or whoever you think is best. That is what he would have said. And that would have inspired you. This is the principle behind endorsements of products. Why do you have a brand ambassador? Sachin Tendulkar is a brand ambassador, and after the Olympics, one or two ads you see, what's his name? Abhinav Bindra. What does it mean? It means the best, a person who's a hero, if he endorses something, he says something, it must be good. Therefore, it sells. Otherwise, why would an organization pay through their nose for one ad? And this is what they had discovered then. So you portray the best in a category, then even an ordinary person gets inspired. Suppose you had said, I am the next door neighbor among cricketers. You will say, so what? You wouldn't get inspired. So therefore, and throughout today, whatever he says, interpret it as, I am Sachin Tendulkar among cricketers. Why? Because he's the greatest. He's hit 12,000 runs. So that's what he's saying here. Now coming back here, he says, I am the beginning, the middle, and the end of all manifestations. It's like the ocean saying, I am the beginning, the middle, and the end of all waves. The ocean has no beginning, middle, or end. The ocean is constant. It's ever present. In the ocean, a wave has a beginning, a wave has an existence, a wave has an end. But even while the wave is going through these manifestations, these changes, if the wave identifies with the ocean, then nothing happens when it goes through these changes. And that is the hint that we get. This is what we learn from these verses. So while you're going through all the changes and the trauma and the stress and strain of daily living, just remind yourself, I am the ocean. Ocean, I am the totality. So what is it that's happening to you? You go through profit and loss, it's just nature trying to readjust. It's like a wave. One wave gets bigger, one wave gets smaller, the ocean remains the same. So if you identify with the total wealth of everybody, nothing happens to you. You identify only with my wealth, then you say, oh my God, meltdown, meltdown. Of knowledges, I am knowledge of the self. So how do you get to this samam? When you have knowledge of the self, then you don't get traumatized by anything else. That is the only knowledge worth knowing. It's like this. In the dream, if you're a Nobel Prize winner, in the dream, if you have got an award for a particular knowledge that you have, does it have any meaning to you as the waker? All knowledges in the dream are ignorance with reference to knowledge of the waker. So the moment you wake up, all the hard work and effort that you have put in to get the Nobel Prize, to get a PhD, to get whatever it is of no value whatsoever. This you understand only after waking up. The wisdom is to understand it while you are in the waking state. That this knowledge that I've acquired is of no use. What is of use? Only knowledge of self, knowledge of the fourth plane of consciousness. And of debates, I am reason. So they say vada. Vada is discussion, debate, arguments. There are three kinds. Jalpa is where arrogantly you assert your opinion. You are not interested in listening to anybody. Everyone else is wrong, only what you say is right. You know, there are people in a social environment, they talk and they continue speaking even when the listener has walked away. Vitanda is one step worse. It's idle criticism. You're just negative in your outlook. You're quick to pick faults with people. Again, there you're not interested in getting at the truth. The only kind of discussion that is worth having is vada, which is a logical sequence of thought arriving at an irrefutable conclusion. So the basis of all this, the starting point, is you want to know the truth. And you don't let go until you arrive at the truth. And it doesn't matter whether you are contributing to it or someone else is contributing to it. Because your dedication is to truth. Then you are open to listening. So among debates, I am reason. Next verse.